There's one case I wanted to show you. I mean, this is something, not a case, but it's something which will start us to think. Do we need to, because now we've last 24 hours, we discussed a lot about correcting the cornea, making it perfect. Dr. Pooja showed one image of a perfect cornea which gives you that wow effect. But have you go back, when you go back to your patients, even if you give them that perfect cornea, they're not happy. Have you seen that? It can give you a wow effect when I want to show you. For example, if you have that post-op, let's assume that post-op is perfect like a LASIK. This is a patient, imagine, if I correct this keratoconus patient, it's a perfect one to prove that my machine is perfect or I'm perfect. But if you really ask patient, they crib, because they have different refractive errors, they're not plano yet. So one thing what we started looking at, which has not been really understood, is one question we ask is, many patients with like this come to us with glass corrected 6x6 vision. When you have a glass spectacle corrected 6x6 vision, it means something is actually making the vision perfect. Because patients are two types in keratoconus. One is perfectly corrected with contact lenses. One is perfectly corrected with glasses, which are the minority. So this patient was somebody who had come to me who was very happy with the spectacle. But I thought he had a big good thickness, so I did the surgery. I'm giving you one prototype, there's enough of them. And he's not happy. He says, I was happy before, I can't see, my weak fraction is varied. Then you get really angry because there's nothing much you can, of course, there's some amount of island there, but his pupils are small. Then we started looking at, we call it the lens biophysics, how each lens is behaving to a particular corneal condition. So we started looking at this. For example, this is a patient. You can see that the astigmatism is here. The lens is not compensating at all for him. And most of it is going. These are the kind of people who probably are not happy with the glasses. Because for them, you need contact lens, because lens is not helping them at all. But there are some people, next slide, look at this. This is, before you start the video, I'll just go into this. This is a abrometer which studies the lens aberration. That means it tells you how the lens is actually balancing to your cornea. So let us have a look at, this is a patient. Can you play this video, please? Just closely look at the lens. The lens is accommodating. This is now the lens is going to accommodate. Exactly the same way as your cornea here. So the lens is actually neutralizing all that you have on the cornea. So what is happening is this guy is completely helped by his lens. So he's happily using his glasses. And what happens after surgery, that compensation is completely lost. So it becomes, the lens becomes erratic because it's trying to accommodate for all kinds of stuff. It doesn't know what it's doing. And that is exactly the reason. One question we have to ask a patient is, how happy are you with your glasses? If the patient says, I'm happy with my glasses, I'm seeing 6-6 vision, do not touch, do not do any laser correction on him in a keratoconus, because he's not going to get a perfect vision. Because glass-corrected patients are the ones where the lens is actually compensating beautifully. Dr. Reddy, have you looked into this? Because I can just play this video again, just for you to, because because this is very important when you go back to your patient and ask. Never correct a patient who has got 6-6 vision with the glasses. You can see this is exactly the mirror image of what is happening here. So, the various reasons. The eye tracy is a static one. It's not, it just picks up at that point, whatever state of accommodation here is. This is giving you stimulus. And it giving a stimulus is actually looking at a real dimension, true dimension of accommodation. And this is a very new insight which I wanted to share, because it is really important to pick, not to pick these patients up for any refractive correction, because they can end up in really, because this is good to show in a conference, this top map here, but his patients are not happy. He, because he gets some, every time he comes, I get a different refraction.
It was compensating earlier, and now there is no stimulus for compensation.
What I feel is, longer your keratoconus, the longer it takes for him to adjust to the new environment. So,
in your case, practically what happened ultimately?
He's still unhappy.
How long?
It's close to a year now. So, I mean, just a thought, in your practice, if you're trying to do a laser correction on a keratoconus, probably this could be just a simple question. Pardon? No, cycloplegic will not help, you know, because you need him to accommodate all the time. I'm just saying how the lens is playing the major factor also in our understanding of what we do with keratoconus.
Maybe an ICL would not.
Yeah. Because what happens is then.
If glasses are correcting, then that, you know, you could just.
Because you're so. It's what I'm trying to say is sometimes it's the nature itself balances, the body itself balances it so well, you don't need to do anything.
Agree.
So in this particular case, it was not necessary for me to have just done a correction for him when probably I did not achieve much. Thank you. Any more cases?
Which one is this one?
This is Osiris. It gives you a, it gives you an accommodation target, and if somebody has an image of that Osiris or the map, Pooja, in your computer, I can just show it and we can end it. It's a very interesting tool. But difficult to understand because it's pure biophysics. Any questions to anybody? This is the last session. And anybody wants to say something? Dr. Gaurav?
You know, I've really enjoyed this session, frankly, because you know, the best part is that we got so much time to discuss, which rarely happens in most meetings, you know. So I think this concept of the way we are doing this is so, so useful, because, you know, everybody can share their information, you can discuss, you can kind of, you know, brainstorm. It rarely happens. Most of the times you just go and you hear a barrage of lectures, and like in a 1 hour session there'll be 2 minutes for discussion, but and this concept is coming out great, so I would first of all congratulate you for this
thanks for being here. Dr. Kumar, because the IOCare people are here, so they can also, I mean, if they decide to take it yearly.
Yeah, thank you, Rohit. You guys may not believe it, but some of you have not seen the main center. Rohit took me today at 5 a.m. Okay, last night we had dinner till whatever time, 11, 12, and then we drove today at 5 a.m., went and saw his hospital, his lab, his center where all the research is done, and came back for the show. And we both are still awake, so that's a good sign. But I want to congratulate you, your team, because you get all the machines here. There's a lot of effort in this to coordinate the whole show and to make sure that everything goes as planned. I mean, to show the toolbox live to people who are already using the Schwind itself was an eye-opener. So we have the equipment and not been able to do everything that we are able to see today. So thank you very much. And I want to thank Lal Bhai. He secretly and told me to keep quiet and not tell everybody, but he's promised me that he wants to do it every year. So secretly I'm telling everyone that we will have it every year. So thank you, everyone.
Anybody wants to say, sir?
I got what I was looking for. I have been using Amaris for last 6 months, and there were so many doubts and so many things in the gray areas which I didn't knew what to do, and this meeting made those points clear, and I think it was a very useful meeting for the users, and the way you had put up the things and a lot of time for discussions that helps to clear the doubts. I think this was a wonderful way
of... If we do it again next year, anything you would suggest the team and all of us here? Anything new formats? Apart from live surgeries?
No live surgeries.
More of case-based discussions where the users can bring their own difficult cases and put them in front of a panel who can give this.
We did think about it. Only thing is we need time.
Time
we need,
for that, yes.
If you bring a case, because we need at least 1.5 days, and 1.5 days would be a best way to take it forward. So anything else?
And we keep this group on app mode and keep on posting our problems there. Maybe that culminates into a good session next year.
Hopefully. So she will end up with, Dr. Reddy, this is for you because you love all this. This is exactly what happens. So just for, no, don't need all this. Just go directly into this. So this is, if you really look at three things there, if you can show accommodation, it's in blue. What happens? The stimulus is in red and the pupil is in green. So basically, when you see those square wave there, so what happens is it gives you a stimulus so that if the pupil is, accommodation is normal, that green color thing, blue color thing should be with under that red color band. That means your accommodation target is not over accommodating. And then it, along with the target coming down, it should come down. Basically, it's optics of our postgraduate optics. The pupil is steady. As the accommodation is there, the pupil does not change. It just constricts, but the lens moves forward. This is the accommodation stimulus. The accommodation stimulus reduces. The lens comes back. The pupil is the same. Again, you give accommodation, it goes up. So that's the concept of this. Use a target, and then, and it also has a video. You can play that video. See, in this patient, even before you give this target, the patient is already at this stage. So there's no need to give a target. That means this patient is in a state of spasm. And normally what we do is, that should be green. It's a typical topographic colors. I'm doing a lot of studies on this. Basically, it's a part of some of our work, but we do it. Very interesting, but now I've started doing it for a lot of my keratoconus patients to understand how much the lens is actually compensating for their illness on the cornea. But if you understand, this is a fantastic tool.
Just to clarify, the device you have used, OSIRIS-T, has now changed his name to Paramis.
Yeah.
So it's absolutely the same device, not to confuse you. Yeah. OSIRIS-T was the original name, and later on by time, the name was changed to Paramis.
So you can buy directly from Schwind.
Or IOL care.
So thank you.